Welcome to two examples of determining a vertical stretch or vertical compression. G of x is a transformation of f of x, where g of x equals a times f of bx. We want to determine the value of a and the value of b. To do this, it'll be helpful to analyze the coordinates of corresponding points. So in f of x, let's find the coordinates of these three key points. Notice how this point would be -6, 0. This point would be 2, 2, and this point would be 6, -1. Then on g of x, let's find the coordinates of this point, and this point. So this point here is still -6, 0. This point here, though, is now 2, 6, and this point here is now 6, -3. So by looking at these two graphs, notice how the x-coordinates have not changed, but the y-coordinates have. This indicates we have a vertical stretch or vertical compression. But notice how the maximum value has increased and the minimum value has decreased. This indicates that f of x has been stretched vertically to form g of x. So we should recognize that means it is going to affect the value of a. We don't have a horizontal stretch or compression because the x-coordinates have not changed, and therefore b would be 1. But let's go ahead and take a moment and review how a and b affect the graph of a basic function f of x. Looking at the value of a, if a is greater than 1, then we have a vertical stretch by a factor of a. Notice if we look at y equals f of x here in blue, y equals 2 times f of x is a vertical stretch. And if we graph y equals 0.5 times f of x, we have a vertical compression. To find points when we have a vertical stretch or compression, we multiply each y-coordinate by a. Now if we take a look at the value of b, where if b is greater than 1, then we have a horizontal compression, which we see here in green by the graph of y equals f of 2x. This is a horizontal compression of the basic function y equals f of x. And then if b is between 0 and 1, we have a horizontal stretch, as we see here by the graph of y equals f of 0.5x. So when we have a horizontal stretch or compression, we multiply the x-coordinates of the parent function by 1 divided by b, or 1 over b. This would also be the same as taking the x-coordinates and dividing by b. So because we already identified that we have a vertical stretch, we'll have to determine the value of a, and because we do not have a horizontal stretch or compression, b would be 1. So looking at the corresponding y-coordinates, we want to determine what we have to multiply the y-coordinates of f of x by to get the y-coordinates of g of x. So let's look at the second point here. Notice that 2 times 3 is equal to 6, and -1 times 3 is also equal to -3. And of course, 0 times 3 is still 0. So because we're multiplying each y-coordinate by 3, that means a would be 3. So we would have g of x equals 3 times f of, again, b is 1, because we do not have a horizontal stretch or compression, so we can just write f of x. So a would be equal to 3, and b would be equal to +1. Let's take a look at a second example. Let's begin by identifying the coordinates of key points on each graph. So for f of x, we'll find the coordinates here, here, and here. So we have -7, -4. Here we have -2, 8. And here we have 6, -6. And then on g of x, we'll find the coordinates here, here, and here. So we have -7, 2. Then we have -2, -4. And then here we have 6, 3. Well, the first thing you might notice is that the y-coordinates have actually changed signs, which indicates that we have a reflection across the x-axis, which means the value of a will be less than 0 or negative. Visually, we should also recognize that in addition to the reflection, f of x has been compressed vertically to form g of x. So it's been vertically compressed and reflected across the x-axis. But notice how the x-coordinates are the same, and therefore we do not have a horizontal stretch or compression, so once again b would be equal to 1. Now let's analyze the corresponding y-coordinates. Here and here. Again, our goal is to determine what constant we have to multiply these y-coordinates by to obtain these y-coordinates. So we want to determine what times negative 4 would be equal to positive 2. Well, negative 4 times negative 1/2 would be positive 2, and 8 times negative 1/2 would be negative 4, and negative 6 times negative 1/2 would be positive 3, which means a must be negative 1/2. So g of x is equal to negative 1/2 times f of x, and therefore a is equal to negative 1/2, and b is equal to positive 1. Remember, b is the coefficient of x, which would be positive 1, because we do not have a horizontal stretch or compression. I hope you found these two examples helpful.